Set phasers to stun. Pew, pew,
pew. Oh, hi, yeah. Welcome back to another episode of Serious Engineering for Serious Engineers.
Serious Engineering.
This is part two of our look at product innovations inspired by Star Trek. In case you didn't see part one, be sure to click the link here, wherever it is. In this episode, we're going to cover a few more innovations, some of them which are real, and a few that are still in the process of being perfected and are just around the corner. Now, to boldly go where no one has gone before. No, that's Star Wars, mate. How did this guy get the job? Dr. Leonard Bones McCoy injected wry commentary and comic relief into many Star Trek adventures when he wasn't injecting Kirk or Spock with some life-saving elixir. But he didn't use a needle. In fact, NBC censors of the time forbid the use of needles as it was too graphic and disturbing. The Hypospray wand allowed him to administer to his patients effortlessly, and these now exist as painless injectors using only air pressure to pierce the top layers of skin.
I can compensate for the atmosphere and the temperature with this. At least it'll give Kirk a fighting chance.
Universal Translator. When traveling to strange star systems, you're bound to encounter beings who don't speak English, with or without good grammar. What do you do? Carry your Universal Translator with you, that's what you do. This handy device automatically analyzes the target language and provides an immediate translation, greatly facilitating interstellar diplomacy. Now we have translation software that can be downloaded as an app on a smartphone, along with the voice recognition AI software like Siri or Alexa that understands spoken commands in natural context-based language. One step closer to universal understanding.
By your feeling for him, you are condemning him to an existence he will find unbearable. He will cease to exist.
He does not age. He remains forever.
You speak of his body. I speak of his spirit.
Wireless earbuds. The communication officer on board the Enterprise was, of course, Lieutenant Uhura, who could be seen at her console forever trying to raise Starfleet command on a subspace frequency. And she wore a stylish stainless steel earbud that, dare we say, she rocked in the 23rd century. This was the first example of wireless earbuds, and not only was it revolutionary, but no one has made it look better. Holodeck. Now we get into more speculative technologies that are still under development. In The Next Generation, viewers were introduced to the holodeck, a special room on the new Enterprise that not only created a realistic virtual reality environment, but that also used fields of force to create solid objects. Many holodeck programs were used for fight training and to visit Sherlock Holmes's 19th century England. Now we have VR goggles to create the visual effects, while haptic feedback sensors provide tactile sensations. We're not quite at full immersion yet, but given the rate of progress on these technologies, we suspect it won't be too far in the future.
It's elementary, my dear Riker.
Sir.
Subspace communication. Every version of Star Trek makes use of subspace radio communication to send and receive messages much faster than the speed of light. Not instantaneous, but very fast. Communication, after all, is essential to keeping the Federation together over vast distances. Now humanity is coming to terms with the strange world of quantum entanglement, a state of matter where two particles share an identical quantum state regardless of physical separation. This spooky action at a distance, as Einstein called it, suggests the ability to share instant data between two points, but so far this is at the very limit of our understanding about how this phenomena works and how to exploit it. Rest assured, people are hard at work trying to make it so.
Make it so, number one.
So, I hope you've enjoyed watching this as much as we've enjoyed putting it together. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and click that bell, and send a comment below via coded subspace transmission, and we'll send an away team to investigate. Remember, we're the folks that bring you serious engineering for serious engineers.
Serious engineering.
Side effects may include a desire to rewatch every movie and TV episode, dress up as your favorite Star Trek character, annoy friends and disturb family members by spontaneously shouting, "Arm photon torpedoes!" at odd random moments, and building a life-size replica of the Bridge of the Enterprise in your basement rec room. Wait a minute, that last one sounds like an awesome idea.
My love is a fever, longing still for that which longer nurseth the disease.
Tell me more.
In faith, I do not love thee with mine eyes, for they in thee a thousand errors see, but 'tis my heart that loves what they despise, who, in despite of view, art pleased to dote. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate.
You didn't tell me that you and Captain Picard were...
You said you didn't want to hear about my other romances.
I have a new love, Jean-Luc.
Logic is the beginning of wisdom, not the end. Captain, I need more thrust!